Wayne Paterson from Anteris. Wayne, good to see you. Good morning.
Morning, Andrew. Thanks for having me. Good to see you.
Look, good to be catching up here. Firstly, the AGM that was held recently here, Wayne. Give us a bit of an update. All resolutions passed.
Yeah, so it was on the 25th, actually, in Sydney. So already a little over a week ago. I was very happy to see the resolutions passed. Obviously, you always are as a CEO. On average, 92-93%. So obviously with a very healthy majority. But I think, you know, for the first AGM face-to-face within 3 years, it was just a great opportunity to meet a lot of our shareholders face-to-face in Sydney who I hadn't had FaceTime with for quite a few years.
And potentially a world first, Wayne, at the AGM, crossing live here to the operating room. Tell us a bit about it.
Yeah, so I was really wanting to bring investors into, get that feeling of what they're invested in beyond the numbers and the things that you usually present at an AGM, which are, of course, very, very important. Talk about the financials and the progress, of which the company has made a lot of progress in the last 12 months. But particularly wanted to give people an understanding of the fact that we are treating patients. We had done 5 previously. We have now done another 8. And I announced that next cohort during the AGM for the first time. So the markets were updated at that point. But we also crossed live to the physicians who are doing the procedures. Then, of course, these patients are in Tbilisi, Georgia. So they're kind of in the middle of the war zone out there. And so it was nice to cross over and take the shareholders into the OR environment. And then we had some footage from the day before of physicians actually in with the patients, and we ran that as well. So the feedback was good. I think people started to get a feeling for the fact that this is not widgets that we make. It's actually products that are life-saving and go into patients.
And how are the first in human studies? How are the cohorts?
Yeah, so the first 5 are doing spectacularly well. And the next 8 we've just done, so I don't have any of the formal update yet. I have, of course, just the anecdotes. Of course, spoken with the physicians, the patients doing particularly well. Again, just a mirror image of the results we saw previously, which is, you know, fantastic mean gradients, fantastic blood pressure results, and so on. So I'm looking forward to updating the markets as soon as I get the formal data analyzed and I can present that to the markets.
Speaking of some of the financials, the numbers here, I see Anteris stock, that's up 35-odd% since the AGM. What are you putting that down to?
I think, you know, the markets were not anticipating necessarily that I would be releasing that next cohort of patients. I think so that obviously drove a lot of that momentum. The company has continued to deliver on its objectives for the last 12 months, particularly. And I think there's just a growing confidence and a re-rate in the market. The company, you know, is really still undervalued quite a lot. When we do an NPV on this company, it's about 750 to 900. Today, US dollars, millions. So we're quite a ways from that in terms of the actual market cap versus the valuation. So I think slowly, as the market confidence builds, people hear the physicians talk about the product, can see what we're doing here, and certainly some of that clinical superiority, you're starting to see that confidence come into the stock.
Talk about confidence building within Anteris. How are your competitors faring?
So I guess, you know, you can look at the stock markets at the moment. You know, Anteris is up, you know, 65% year to date, which in the current environment is pretty pleasing. And, you know, there's some resilience there. If I take some of the other players, Medtronic is about 10% down year to date. Edwards Life Sciences, who are, you know, probably our biggest competitor when we get to market, are down about 25% year to date. So whilst the other companies are negative, and that's a function a little bit of course, what's happening in the global stock markets, but at least year to date, we're certainly up dramatically in front of our peers. So I'm happy with that performance. I don't think it's an indictment on the other companies. I think it's just a function of where the markets are, but we're certainly outperforming at the moment.
Of course, recently, just back, as we said at the start from the AGM in Sydney, we've got the TVT Summit in Chicago this week. What's happening there, Wayne?
Right. So we're pretty excited. You know, this is really the beginning of the podium season, as we call it. TVT is actually tomorrow in Chicago. So we're heading off there. So these kind of industry conferences are, they're academic. That's where the latest data is presented on the podium. The physicians of note and the real opinion leaders in the space are, of course, all presenting data and so on. We are presenting in the innovation session as well, but we also get to see what other folks are presenting. So it's always a big deal, but the networking with physicians and other company executives also important at these conferences. So you can bet there's a lot of things that get talked about on the sidelines at these meetings, that's for sure.
And what can we, just looking ahead to the remainder of 2022, Wayne, what can we expect from Anteris?
So I think it's really a year of really a lot of news between, especially from now until the end of the year. So, you know, the markets know that we have a pending FDA study approval coming. I can say that's imminent. We've got a bunch of, you know, podiums from the data. We've got the data coming out for the last cohort of patients. We'll have FDA study patients going through. And that'll culminate with London Valve, PCR London Valve in November, which is the big meeting of the year for TAVR and valve-related topics, where we'll be on the podium, hopefully presenting late-breaking data on our FDA study as well as the Tbilisi patients. So there's a lot coming this year.
A busy few months ahead. Always good to speak, Wayne. Thanks very much.
Great. Thanks, Andrew. Appreciate the time.